Welcome back, students, to your social studies class. So today we were going to learn the second chapter of the second periodic course, which is From Cave Drawings to the Web. So in this chapter we will learn regarding the various means of communication, the inventions of inventors, personal means of communication and popular means of communication. So before starting the chapter, let us first know regarding communication. So communication means exchanging of information by speaking, writing or using some other mediums. So communication then and now. Early humans communicated emotions and thoughts through gestures, means movement or sign, and sounds. They also drew pictures on the walls of the caves where they lived. In India, such cave paintings can be seen at Vimbetka in Madhya Pradesh. So they used to draw pictures on the wall of the caves in order to communicate. Gradually, early humans developed a system of drawing shapes to talk to each other, and this was the birth of language, which is how we communicate these days. Before postal service was introduced, people used to send letters and messages over long distance on either horseback or through pigeons. But later, telegraphs and telegrams were used. Primitive man, however, communicated by using signs and pictures called pictographs. But as language developed, men started writing first on clay tablets, leaves and then on papers. And nowadays, we are using emails and other electronic forms of paperless communication. Okay, so where paper is not used. Meet the inventors. So, Alexander Graham Bell at the age of 29 invented the telephone. Samuel Morse, an American, invented the single wire telegraph system, which is based on the European telegraph. John Logie Baird was a Scottish engineer who is known for being the first person to demonstrate a working television. Okay, and Guglielmo Marconi is regarded as the father of long distance radio transmissions. So they are some of the inventors. Nowadays, we listen to the radio and watch televisions to find out about news and events which are occurring all around the world. But way back in 1969, when Neil Armstrong first reached the moon, people learned about it through the radio. Radio is still a popular medium of communication. It is used now also. The first television set were not only bulky and large, but showed everything in black and white. So they are not only big in size, heavy, but everything in black and white. The advancement in technology, LCD, LED, plasma televisions, etc., are popular in the market these days. So now we can see different types of television sets, like LCD, LED, plasma televisions, etc. Okay, so now regarding personal communication. First is postal services. The postal services was established during the 19th century. These days, post offices are situated at every corner of the world. And people drop postcards and letters in post boxes, and from there these letters are collected and taken to the post offices, sorted and then sent to the address in where they were supposed to go. So in order to cover the expense of carrying out their entire process, they use stamp of various amounts which are attached on the letters, envelopes, aerograms and parcels. So they are taken to their respective destination either through road, air or railways. Now the next one is fax. So fax machine scan documents and then send them through telegraph wires. So this way documents can be sent to even far off places, and we can also send pictures through fax machines. Okay, so it scan the document and then it's sent through telegraph wires. The next is telephone and mobile. So we are quite familiar with this step of communication, right? So until a few years back, telephones in India were seen only few households and mobile phones were almost unheard of. But in fact, to talk to someone in another city or country, one had to request an operator to book a trunk call, which would take a long time to connect. So talking to a people to a far place, to another country or another city, takes a lot of time, okay, to connect. But nowadays cell phones have become an essential part of everyone's life. So from a fisherman out at sea to farmers in the field, everyone has a phone. Cell phone works everywhere because they do not require fixed lines like the telephones of yesteryears. So they work through a system of cellular phone towers and satellites around the earth. Now this provides signals to many wireless cell phones. So communication satellites enables a lot of data transmissions like television signals, phone signals, data signals and weather information. The latest invention in the world of mobile phones are the smartphones and the tablets. Okay, and these devices are capable of a wide range of functions such as connecting to the internet, writing and reading emails, and even it is also used to locate places such as cinema halls, restaurants, malls, etc. The next one is mass media. So mass media is a medium that is used to communicate a lot of people at once. Okay, so it's a medium to communicate a lot of people at the same time, like radio, books, television, newspaper, internet, magazine. So these are all the forms of mass media. Now radio, television and newspaper. So radio can be described as a wireless communication device, and it is used for listening to news, educational programs, songs and entertainment shows. Television also serves the same purpose, but television is a visual medium and radio is an audio medium. So with television, entertainment has gained a new meaning. Why? Because we can see the different types of channels are there. There are a lot of variety of television channels are there, like wildlife are there, cooking channels are there, okay, entertaining channels are there, cinema channels are there. So one can find books, magazines and newspaper in different languages. This newspaper helps to inform us about everything that happens in our country and the world. And this medium, that is especially the newspaper and magazine, are used by people to advertise their product and services also. So we can also notice advertisement of products and services in the newspaper. So now let us know regarding advertisements. So advertisements have also become important means of communication these days because they inform us about different products and services which are available to us. Often goes advertisements to spread messages of awareness and important issues. So just for example, in this pandemic situation also we can see different type of awareness guidelines have been given, right? Now, advertisement provides in newspapers and magazines do not reach a lot of people as many cannot read. Okay, but this gap is filled by radio and television. So these days even the internet is used for advertising. Now the next is internet. So earlier messages and letters took days to reach their destination. As we have learned earlier, right, it took a lot of time to communicate. But nowadays we use emails or electronic mail to send messages instantly to any part of the world. And this is possible because of the internet, which is also called the information highway. Okay, so internet is also called as information highway. We can do a lot more than just sending emails or messages. So what we can do more, we can do e-banking, shopping, book tickets and search for information on any topic on the internet. Internet also enables advanced forms of communication like video chatting and conferencing. So it makes our communication more lively, right? Now the next is cinema. So cinema is another form of communication which is extremely popular. Due to its wide reach, it is very powerful medium of public communication. Okay, and a film can communicate ideas in an entertaining and also create awareness on social issues. So we can see that many films are there, no, which makes the people aware of the social issues which are going on nowadays. So they also bring forth the inspiring stories of great men and heroes also. A film can be viewed only after obtaining a censor certificate. So after the film has been made, it can get viewed only after it gets the censor certificate. So a film that has been given a U certifications can be watched by children. Okay. A UA certification requires children below the age of 12 years to be accompanied by their parents. So these are some of the certifications. Documentaries are films that show actual situations and are more informative. So documentary film shows actual situations, okay, and they are also very much informative. So a short note has been given here. In 1448, Johannes Gutenberg of Germany invented the printing press, which led to the mass production of written documents. Okay, so he invented the printing press. So students, in this chapter we have learned regarding the various means of communications. Okay, so how we communicate in earlier days and how with the advancement of technology we are communicating nowadays. Okay, and also we have learned regarding some personal means of communication and also some mass media. Okay, so I hope students, this video will help you to understand this chapter, and soon we will meet in our next class. Till then, stay safe. Thank you.